Wait. That is the biggest, like, non...
Oh, it is showing.
That is the biggest non-tarantula spider I've ever seen in my life.
I think she's pregnant.
Oh, my... Lanta. Is that, like, is that a wolf spider?
That thing is so big. Don't point at me. Point it at
your
that.
Your reaction is great.
Point it at that thing.
Oh my God.
Anybody want to go boondocking? This is why people hate boondocking.
Another beautiful sunset. This one, I don't know if they get better and better and better, but this one is literally 360 degrees.
Want to see a sneak peek of the inverter we put in? Pretty stoked on finally having an inverter again. We have not, we've had the batteries in for a few weeks now, and the inverter just brings it to a whole nother level. I'll be, of course, doing a kind of full video on the installation of this and everything.
Oh, I'm spying on you.
Are you peeking back here?
Yeah, it's fun.
But I really like how it turned out. Pretty clean. I had to drill some holes back there to get the cables through to under the bed, and mounting, pretty good spot. It's not bad. My original plan was to put it right in the middle of the pass-through because that's where the wires were gonna go through. Instead of having the wires come out like that, because on the back side of this is a cabinet, so we can't, it's not really a cabinet, it's actually the front of our nightstand tables, so you can't drill anything to the back side of that, though I did mount a piece of wood so that that has a better stability for a mounting block. But so far, we are loving this thing, and it allows us to do things like this.
I need some juice! We have power, people. That's it.
What do you think? First time using that bad boy.
It's fun.
First time we've had a vacuum cleaner in a real vacuum cleaner in many years.
It's been 3 years since we've owned a vacuum. And look at all the dirt it got out. It was definitely powerful. I like it. It feels like it's on that ball motion. Does it have a ball motion down here?
Well, it's got the duo heads so that you see the orange roller and then the yellow one behind it. That way it can do hardwood floors and carpet. That's why we got this one, because we have both. And instead of using different attachments, so that kind of makes it like turn a little bit harder because it's the brush is always rotating.
Oh, that's what I'm feeling.
Yeah, so it has a little bit of like resistance to it.
Mm-hmm.
But that's why you get that. I did some vacuum research. That's the best I found, was this Shark Duo Clean, whatever model it is.
Any person with medium to long hair knows you'll be shedding some long hairs around.
Mm-hmm. So anyways, very nice to have a vacuum cleaner and power to be able to run it, and I don't know, amazing, isn't it?
The little things makes you feel like home.
Mm-hmm.
Like chores.
Like cleaning it.
Like cleaning.
nice slippers.
Thank you.
Nice fish slippers.
Thank you.
I wasn't gonna put the solar panel up because we were gonna go to another location, but we decided to stay here for another couple days because it's just so darn peaceful. We finally got one neighbor that is, I don't know how many hundreds and hundreds of feet or yards away over there. But other than that, like, we just can't see anybody. So I'm gonna put the little 90 watt Zamp out, and it's pretty easy to deploy. They're really nice to have because, especially if you have a solar port for it, because you basically just plug it in and point it towards the sun. That's it. You don't even have to turn it on. You just plug it in. That's the battery voltage, 13.2. If I switch it, 4.3 amps. That's about the max this thing kind of puts out. Let me angle a little bit more at the sun there. I don't think I've seen 5 amps out of this, so around that high 4.5. But you can just point it at the sun all day long and get a pretty good charge up on the battery. So I mean, we're running the fantastic fans on top. We got two of them just to kind of keep it a little bit cooler. It's 85 degrees out now, and that's getting pretty toasty no matter what kind of RV you're in. 85 degrees, sunshine, pretty toasty. A little bit of breeze, which helps out quite a bit, but other than that, we definitely are looking forward to being able to pump the air conditioner just a little bit. You know, when we have 1200 watts of solar, that's pretty good, enough to maybe run the air conditioner for like an hour when it gets really hot at, like, let's just say 3 o'clock, run it from 3 to 4, let it cool down a little bit right when we're getting to that unbearable temperature. So now, instead of the batteries being depleted, they're actually getting just a small charge, because like I said, we're only got 4.5 amps going into the battery. So now that's enough to run the fantastic fans, or max air fans we have in this. And otherwise, it's getting a little toasty in here, isn't it?
Yeah, that fan feels really good. It actually pulls a nice flow.
Yeah, don't ask me why I'm looking at oranges on my laptop. We'll tell you later.
Orange, you glad I didn't ask?
Just got done grilling up a whole Blackstone full of chicken breasts. No, chicken thighs.
Chicken thighs. I like chicken thighs a lot more than breasts.
Yeah.
They're so delicious. We eat them quite often. We eat a lot of things quite often, but we've been eating really good. Love having all the fridge space for all the veggies. So we're certainly eating the rainbow, and that's how both of us feel best. Lots of lean meat, lots of plants, and it doesn't get any better than that. So it's a working lunch. We're gonna sit down, have some lunch, and keep on plugging away on our computers.
Is that bacon?
Yes, you got some bacon in there.
Yeah. Love it.
Thanks for grilling.
No problem.
Yeah, I love it too. I'm excited. Forgot some avocado in the fridge. I'm gonna grab that. Oh, I'd like to share a little tip about my avocados. Since you are filming me right now. The way I like to keep them stored, I know a lot of people will take the half and then whatever's left, and they'll put like tin foil over it or cling wrap over it. What I like to do is I like to take out whatever I'm gonna eat. So in this case, probably just like a quarter of it. I'm gonna put that in here. And then with my remainder, I like to put it right back together just like this, because that gets about as airtight as possible. And then I put it in a baggie And I find this method keeps it fresher for a long time. So even if I took the whole half and it was an empty half, I would still sandwich the shell back together the same way and use its entire skin as part of storing it fresh. It works really, really good. Try it.
Okay, time to eat. Oh, and look at this.
Pretty proud of myself on this one. I found a wood board in the back of the truck. Same one that I used to mount the inverter, actually, and the same one that I mounted the batteries under the bed. And I just set it underneath the step there to create a little platform. Now we got room for our hiking shoes. Keeps them off the ground. Keeps the scorpions and the tarantulas out of them.
Woo, it is getting hot this week. We're now on day four. We're just about to hit 4 days exactly. It's the evening right now. And it's been hot. It's warming up. It was like 86 today. Did you say 88?
88.
Close to 88 degrees. And so this is kind of our first experience with boondocking and some heat in the new RV. And it's quite a bit different than the van.
It is so much more comfortable than the van for a heat without the AC. So that van, it was just like a literally a metal box that attracted, radiated on the inside. At least in here, there's a little bit more room to groove with the wind.
Like the walls are made out of 2-inch thick styrofoam, and it does pretty good. So like it resists the heat quite a bit. There's not a ton of, there is metal, aluminum, you know, structure in there as well, but it seems to do pretty good with the heat. And I think having that extra space, you know, the van was a metal box and we were like, you know, kind of like, all, we were inside the oven, basically. The whole thing was a little oven.
I was
oven.
A toaster strudel.
I mean, it was pretty good, but I have to say, this RV is better. It is not like a cure-all, though. Like, it's still hot
and we,
when it's like this.
We haven't blasted our AC at all. So if we had our solar panels up, which we do not yet, would we have done some short bursts for relief?
Absolutely. That's a big, big game changer. We're at, like, 60% in battery right now after 4 days. I just put the solar panel out yesterday, the 90 watt one. So if we were pumping in 1,000 watts of solar every day, we'd be doing really, really good. And just like an hour or even like a half hour of that air conditioner would be
just a couple of 5 minute spurts. I don't even need a whole hour. Just give me a spurt.
A little bit of relief.
And I made ice in our freezer. So even just having a glass of ice cold water like helps a lot. We've been chugging water. We're getting low on our bubbly water, so that's on ration. But lots of water, having those daily showers helps.
Yeah, the showers is a big deal. Our water supply is doing really good. It just, I want to say yesterday after I took a shower, it went down to 2/3. And so, of course, this is the antiquated sensor system that is completely horrible. So black tank, as soon as you use your black tank, it automatically doesn't work. Just 2 minutes ago, it said full, then 2/3, now 1/3. We have no idea what that is, but that's just kind of the way it is. Same thing with the gray tank, that doesn't work. Your fresh usually stays clean and the sensors always work.
But once you get down to 1/3, you have no idea when the ticking time bomb is gonna go off.
So here's how it works. We have 70 gallons of fresh water. So 70 gallons.
Not 80.
Not 80, just 70. 70 is at full. From light on to light off is 17.5 gallons.
What do you mean, light on to light off?
Let me go from zero. So if your light is on empty, that could mean you have 0 gallons of water or 17.5.
Oh, okay.
So same thing with 1/3. So it goes up. So it should be like 0, 17.5, 35, 52.5, and then up to 70.
Yeah.
But your range sensor is what's so messed up, because like you said, full could either mean 70,
right,
or it can mean 53 gallons.
Yeah.
Because as soon as it hits 52.5, the light should go out and it goes to 2/3.
Yeah, that makes sense. So that's a big range.
So there's a 17.5 gallon discrepancy to what, yeah. So as soon as the empty light goes on, we have roughly 17.5 gallons.
But as soon as you're on the final third, then it's like really, until like, it's for us, it's hard to manage because we are fresh into it. So we don't really have like our day counts down yet.
And if you're not paying attention, you don't know if you just hit empty or if you're down to literally like 2 gallons left because you weren't paying attention.
Is it your first day on 1/3 or your third day on 1/3?
Yeah. So, I mean, I just got to say that's a bad system. Like for it to say empty, but still have 17.5 gallons or for it to say full and be down 15 gallons. Like that's not a good system.
Speaking of fresh water though, today I was gleaming about the fact that we no longer need to fill up water containers. Mm-hmm. Not to say we won't ever someday down the road for like a surplus of fresh water, but for like basic necessities to go out for 1 to 2 weeks to not have to do that, huge relief. We were spending so many days filling up water jugs, lugging them around. Like, I don't know. Like, I think that right there is a big red flag that like we were outgrowing of our van because we couldn't even consume water the way we wanted to.
Yeah, and I would say after 4 days, we've probably used maybe like 25 gallons or something like that.
And we're drinking a lot.
And that's what the van would have had for a total capacity, roughly.
I'm filling up the Berkey about 3 times a day.
Also, with our surplus of fresh water, I have switched and we are not using any paper products at all, with the exception of a rubber glove to handle raw chicken every now and then. But we've been using regular dishware that we wash, and regular utensils. Like, we haven't done any paper, and it feels really good. You know, coming out of that tent for 3 months when we were using paper for every meal, we were a little bit papered out, and it feels really good to be eating on normal dishware again. So that helps us with our trash a lot, but it's also putting a dent in our fresh water. We don't really know how long we can go. Like, in the van, we always used paper plates because we were so low and limited on water all the time. So that's one big swing that we're experimenting with that's totally different from what we did before. Hopefully it works out and we'll still be comfortable for a week while washing dishes, because this sink is awesome. It's huge. And washing dishes no longer gives me anxiety anymore, because in the van, like, you had nowhere to set anything. You know, and if you had dirty dishes around, you had nowhere to put clean dishes. So the setup is just a dream. And hopefully we can continue to use all regular dishes, or at least a mix, so it's mostly dishes. And if we need to weave in some paper for long trips, we'll do that. But ideally, we do this all the time. So into trash management, because we haven't been using paper, that helps a lot. Our big yellow bag is missing right now. It's somewhere in the truck. We don't know where. We've each spent like 20 minutes here or there looking for it, and we're like, I can't look for it anymore. But I think we have one of those kitchen bags about half full.
Yeah, it's getting pretty full.
It's getting there, but we're not like swimming trash out of our ears yet. We're doing pretty good.
Being able to throw it in the back of the truck is just way different than putting it inside of our living space.
Yeah, not having trash in your living space is so nice, and just having space to let things sit out. Like, I don't know, like, can you tell that we really like having more space? It's just so amazing for us. We're so comfortable. Every day I look at Aaron and I say, this is just great. And I don't know when he's gonna get sick of me saying that, but hopefully never.
And we're new to this style of awning. Our van had the legless like auto sensor awning. No arms at all. It just came out and auto sensed back in if it got too windy. And so we're still getting used to this, but this is kind of cool that you can slide these down. Oh my God.
What?
Come out here.
Is there an animal? Let me get my shoes on. I don't like the look on your face.
Look at that spider.
Yeah, it's pretty big.
Oh.
Yeah, that's really, the legs look like crab shell legs.
I feel like it's gonna jump at me. Oh man.
I don't know what I was saying about the awning, but I...
we'll talk about that later.
I totally forgot about the awning. I can't concentrate.
What you were saying is that this is new to us.
Yeah,
the you could like extract it, put it in, but you couldn't angle it.
Yeah, you couldn't angle it down. So angling it down is nice to kind of help with the sun.
With the sun angle.
I'm distracted by that thing. Spiders never show up big on camera.
Well, you need like a quarter or something to scale it. Ooh. For scale.
It's just big. Wow, Arizona. Pretty. One little cacti up there. Amazing.
Moment of truth. We're going to open up our avocado from last night. That was just last night, right?
I have no idea.
I think sure it was. No, it was 2 nights ago because we had tacos last night. Okay. 2 nights ago. 48 hours. Pretty good. It's not perfect, but it's pretty dang green. For 2 days later, guys.
I'm not sure what I'm looking at or looking for.
Well, it turns brown. So there's a little bit of brown on there, but it could be worse.
Yeah, no, I've seen you do that before. It seems to work.
Yeah, and another thing I like to do is do pickled red onions in red vinegar. It lasts a really long time, and just a few of these really makes any dish pop. So those are my tips for right now. That's all I got. We got green beans going. I'm gonna do tomatoes, onions, avocado.
Burgers.
Aaron's having a burger. I'm having a burger. Make sure you make mine rare, please.
Sure.
Okay.
You but careful, there's a lot of bugs out here, a lot of bugs and a lot of giant spiders that are eating those little bugs.
Well, thank you for going out there and facing them. Delicious.
Yeah, I can see why that giant spider liked our awning, because when you turn the light on, the bugs just like flock to it. He's probably just sitting up there munching on little flies.
Everybody's eating.
Yeah, so I looked him up. He's a giant Arizona crab spider. Scary.
I said he looks like little crab legs.
Yeah. That's why they call him a crab spider, because he kind of like moves like one, looks like one. Whew. Scary.
Well, thank you for cooking. Let's dig in and relax.
I'm good. All right, today. Good morning.
Good morning.
It's day 8. We made it officially a full week, our first full week of boondocking. I mean, I can sum it up with just one word, one sentence. I showered every day but one. Every day but one, I showered.
I showered every day but one. Plus, today I haven't showered because we're in such a hurry to get out of here.
So, what did I shower? 7 times? You showered 6 times?
Yeah.
Because today's day 8, technically?
Yeah. I didn't wash my hair every day. Some days I would do neck down shower, and that saves a ton of water.
Yeah, absolutely.
Plus,
amazing.
I don't want to be washing my hair every day, because that's bad for your hair.
Yeah, that's tough to do while boondocking.
Yeah.
Amazing experience. The 810 amp hours of Battleborn batteries are at 30%. We used 625 lithium amp hours, and I did use the solar panel about 2.5 days, the 90 watts.
I didn't use my air fryer or my hair dryer. Those are two things that I'm really excited to be able to use once we have our panels up.
We would have ran the air conditioner a few times for sure.
Yeah.
Fresh water still says 1/3. It's been saying 1/3 for a couple days. So I think that's about to hit empty. And when it hits empty, that really means it's at the beginning of a quarter.
Which means we
which
have
is
17.5 gallons.
Nice. And our black tank, it just hit the full mark this morning. What does that mean?
We have 10 gallons remaining.
Nice. 10 of our 40 gallons of black. And gray, we are at 2/3. What does that mean?
That means we have 17.5 gallons remaining.
No. Nope.
10 gallons remaining. 20 gallons remaining.
That means we are in between 20.
Wait, did we just hit that?
Oh, we don't know. That's why we're in between the scale now.
Okay.
So now we're in.
But if we just hit it, then we'd have 20 remaining.
We didn't though. So now we're in between.
I didn't get all the information on that trick question.
All we can say is that we're in between 20 and 30 gallons.
Full.
Full.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Between 10 and 20 remaining.
As soon as that hits the full mark.
Let's call it. We have 15 remaining.
Then it'll be 10. So we have no idea. That's why this system is horrible. If you haven't heard me complain about it enough. Otherwise, that's it. I don't know. The scenery, the sunrises, the sunsets, the saguaros, everything.
We got to enjoy
absolutely amazing.
360 degrees of pure beauty here. Every morning, we sat there, and we woke up in the dark, and it was great, because we'd have our coffee and laptop time as the sun rose. It was amazing.
We had a few people say, why would you switch from the van to this RV when it takes so much to hook up and so much to drag around? This is exactly why. So we could boondock for comfortably 1 week and stretch it up to we don't know what yet, but we're thinking 2 weeks. So we could go 1 week in the van, but that was doing some very, very hardcore conservative
stuff. Let's say this.
Oh, paper products.
We already talked about paper products.
Oh.
We've already talked about that, but what I want to say is zero red solo cup. The red solo cup is dead, guys. It's a RIP situation. Unless we're getting crazy and trying to stretch out to like 3 weeks or something.
Little red solo cup.
But not only is it more comfortable for boondocking, our decision for the trailer, it's just more comfortable for every single second that we're in here.
We still didn't leave. We have a truck parked outside. We didn't leave once.
I know that we're not used to having a vehicle. Like we are, we're going to change that though.
But we ran about 35 cumulative miles.
This week, that's what we did?
I don't know, 30 miles, something like that.
Yeah.
Anyways, what are we doing with the knife?
Ah! I'm in pack-up mode. And we put these away when we drive.